Up next on Evening Magazine, for Kids' Sake, reporter Jason Weiner becomes a roadie for some punk rockers.
I think you'd be hard-pressed today to find any teenager that doesn't like music. Probably the kind of music would be the subject of a discussion. Jason Weiner says that punk music and its many variations are popular here. In fact, some of the kids are making their own tunes. Tonight he checks it out with a group called The Criminally Insane.
These Baltimore teenagers are making themselves heard, expressing their feelings with a song of their own creation. Whether you like it or not, the music of The Criminally Insane is on its way out. Out on an album, that is.
This is going to be your first nationwide exposure, on vinyl at least.
Skiz, known as the den father of Baltimore punk, is producing an album that will include 8 to 10 of the area's up-and-coming but unexposed punk groups. Here at the Commercial Refinery, he and musician-engineer Michael Collins are hard at work helping the bands get it all together.
A lot of these bands are more into playing for the fun of it and as a hobby, and they are young. They haven't gotten as old where they're to the point where it's got to be so incredibly professional and taken so very serious that the fun has been lost.
For all the fun, cutting a song for an album is hard work. The song is recorded time and again until everyone is satisfied. With a song as intense as this one, it can get tiresome.
The chorus?
Yeah. Yeah. Can you, man? Because I really don't want to listen to it.
We've heard it enough times as it is.
Listening back in the control room with fans and members of other bands inspires a little spontaneity. A group sing on the final chorus.
Here's my chance.
Tired of learning, it's all lies. Tired of lies, just want the truth. Tired of the truth, give me more lies. See the vicious cycles you put us through.
I don't recommend that you try this one at home. And let me remind you that all the songs on the album are different, reflecting the personalities of each band. Skiz says he hopes his album will shed a new light on what people think of punk.
The music might not be exactly what you'd like to listen to yourself, but it's doing something good and positive. You turn on the Top 40 radio and there's all kinds of songs about drinking, sex, and driving fast. And you listen to a punk album and there's a lot of stuff about thinking and peace and trying to get along with your friends and your fellow man.
So get ready, Baltimore. A new wave of music is coming your way.
Yeah, perfect.
Not exactly your traditional rock and roll, would you say?
No, you can always rely on young Jason to uncover a new wrinkle.
Yes, and he has. The music of The Criminally Insane and other local groups are going to be on an album called Squash Dance, and you can look for it in November.
Like that title.
Yeah.
You can always get something kind of new and crazy and zany from young people.
No.